You know, it feels like forever since September 10th when the Surface Duo first released, but in fact, it's only been a few months. Right after the Surface Duo released, I released a 15, almost 16 minute long video called Surface Duo Tips and Tricks. This video got almost 4,000 views and was received, you know, pretty well. I figured though, after all this time has gone by, there are definitely a few tips and tricks that I have learned since September 15th, which was only 5 days after the Duo came out. Definitely some things that I've learned that might be worth sharing with you guys. So consider this a Surface Duo Tips and Tricks Part 2. I will say if you haven't watched Part 1 though, it is still probably worth a watch. There may be some things in there that maybe you don't know, maybe you know all of them, I don't know, but it's probably still worth at least checking out. Okay, so the first one is one that I actually didn't know about for like a really long time. Like I'd seen it shown in some of the videos for the Duo, but I'd never taken the time to try to use it. And it's kind of funny that I never did, or that I didn't for so long, I should say, because I did eventually. And what this is the ability to drag text from one screen to the other screen. So like if you wanted to copy text from an article and then tweet that text, you can long press it and slide it over. So let me show you exactly what that would look like. So let's say I'm on a website and I want to copy that text there and I want to tweet it. Now look, you could simply long press, hit copy, come over here, and then paste it. You can do that, and that's going to be totally fine. That works just fine. However, there's something strangely satisfying to me about long pressing the text to highlight it and then just simply dragging it into place. And it even is retaining the fact that it was bold. Now, Twitter won't know what to do with that, but in other things, it will know what to do with that. In fact, if you were to use this in conjunction with OneNote, let's say you're going to long press this text. We're going to go all the way down to here. And I drag this over to my OneNote. It's even going to pull the image over, guys. Like, this works really, really well. And if you're like me and you take notes to make videos with, man, this is like an awesome feature that I don't think enough people know you can do. Okay, so here's another one. I've talked a lot about the gestures being a little bit wonky. Well, there's a couple of things that you can do that will improve, I think, for most of you, the experience of navigating the Surface Duo with gestures. So if you go into your settings and then you look for system settings and then we go to gesture navigation, there's two things that you're going to want to do. First, disable this, double tap to dismiss. So what that is they want you to be able to double tap the little bar down here, your little bar for navigation to go home. And in my experience, one, I absolutely never do that because it's such a small spot. But two, when I disable it, it seems as though my swipes up to go home, they seem a bit more consistent and a bit smoother. This could be a placebo effect. I don't know for sure, but in my experience, turning off, turning on for days at a time, it seems to be better turned off. Your mileage may vary, but I do recommend turning that off. Then if you go into navigation and bring up your little gear here, your back sensitivity. So as it shows in the little animation here, swiping over from the side is how you go back, obviously. Well, this allows you to change the sensitivity of that gesture. Now, I've noticed in some apps like Relay for Reddit, that back gesture is just too sensitive. Or even if you're spanned, you know, see, you're having one app spanned across both screens and turned vertically. Sometimes when I'm just scrolling up, I will wind up going back. Well, to prevent that, change that sensitivity from defaults to here. I drop it all the way down to low, and that seems to get rid of those phantom backs that I accidentally will do from time to time. Just seems to make the overall experience just a little bit smoother. I still think Microsoft can do a little bit, or actually probably a lot, to make these things better on their own with a little bit of tweaking, but this will help a little bit. Okay, so what about if you're one of these people that have put a skin on their Duo, or you like to change up the look of your Duo? Maybe you've already put your bumper on, but you want to get a skin from Soppy Guard, who knows, or from Dbrand, and you're thinking, man, I got to pull my bumper off, and the adhesive's going to be dead. It's not going to work anymore. But I do want to put my bumper back on, but of course, once I peel it off, that adhesive just isn't going to work well anymore. Well, there is a very simple solution that will cost you only $8 for the rest of your entire life, because you can buy from Amazon this 3M double-sided adhesive that looks to me to be the exact same thing that this thing came with. As you can see, I have purchased it myself because I am getting ready to skin my my Surface Duo, and I'm going to put my bumper back on. So I bought this. It appears to be the correct size. It comes in a roll that is like so much more than you're ever gonna use. Like, you're gonna you can take your bumper off a million times and you're gonna be totally fine. So that's an easy solution there. There will be a link to that stuff in the comments down below, and it is an affiliate link. So if you do buy it through that link, or if you click that link and then buy anything, that's a great way to help support the channel. Okay, so let's talk about the default camera app. One of the biggest complaints about the default camera app is the shutter lag. And what that means is you hit the button to take a picture and the Duo goes, oh, let me think about it for a second. And then it takes the picture and the picture is smeared or you missed the shot, whatever, it looks bad. Shutter lag is super, super annoying. One of the weirder things about the shutter lag that I've noticed is it seems to be worse in brighter areas. Typically, it's the opposite. Typically, when it's dark, the shutter, basically the shutter stays open longer to bring in more light. With the Duo, it seems to be worse in brighter light for me. And I've seen that on two different Surface Duos. I would love to know if more of you guys can back that up and say, yeah, inside the house where it's a little bit dimmer, the shutter lag's better than when I go outside and it's brighter. I'd love to know if more people have experienced that. I have solved that problem of shutter lag for me because I just don't use the default camera app any longer. So what I've been using is this build of Gcam Go. This link will also be in the description. Super, super simple. If you want to install this thing, you're just going to click on this link here on your Surface Duo, download that. When you go to install it, you may need to allow unknown sources or allow Edge or Chrome or whatever your browser is to install APKs. You'll have a pop-up. It's really straightforward. It'll basically ask you, are you sure you want to install this? Are you sure you want to let your browser install programs? Say yes. It'll install. And basically what you're going to get from that is a camera app that just works better. I think that the picture quality in the default app might be slightly better because there's HDR available, whereas the Gcam Go does not currently have Gcam, although there is maybe HDR coming to the Gcam Go in the near future. Fingers massively crossed for that one. But at the end of the day, the shutter lag is it's effectively just non-existent. And if you look at the app, and this is going to look a little bit weird because, you know, here I am and there I am. But this is what the program essentially looks like. You've got portrait mode on this build. You actually even do have access to night mode, which is not great, but it's like better than not having night mode. And the shutter lag itself, I'll give you an example here. If I click the shutter, that's it. That's the shutter lag. It's so much better. And it's like that regardless of what's going on. So let's talk about typing for a second. One of the things that I've saw as a complaint from some people, like maybe a particularly bitter, venomous, angry review from Ars Technica, was that there's no split thumb keyboard on the Duo. Well, there actually is. What you do, if you pull up any program and then you simply span it, if you then go to type something, there is an option to enable this style keyboard where you have a gap in the middle, you can hold like this and use your thumbs to type. To enable that, all you have to do is you have to hit these little arrows here, and there's the option there for thumb typing. Works totally fine. I actually don't really like to use the thumb typing all that much, but I'm also, it's there if I want to use it, I just have to span. Otherwise, if you're on one screen like so, you're just going to get the regular slid over keyboard style for one thumb typing. But again, if you want to use the thumb split style typing, it is there as an option for you to use. Now this is on the Swift Key keyboard. I'm not using Gboard or anything like that. That is the default keyboard for the Surface Duo. Let's talk about battery life and a very simple thing that you can do to actually improve your battery life. These screens on the Surface Duo are both AMOLED displays, which basically means that if the screen is showing something black and it's true black, the pixels simply will not be on, which means they're not using power. So this is true of all AMOLED devices. Using a wallpaper that consists mostly of black or dark colors uses considerably less power. On a device like the Surface Duo that has two very large AMOLED displays, this is even more true. So the advantage you would get of using a black wallpaper on a Pixel 3 is less than the advantage you would get doing the same on the Surface Duo, because the screens are just a lot bigger, and it's just math, okay? On my Surface Duo, I tend to get somewhere in the 5 to 7 hours of screen on time a day. It really just depends on how hard I'm pushing the thing. And I generally keep a darker wallpaper. I've experimented with brighter wallpapers, and I actually feel like I can notice the battery life being a little bit worse. At its worst, with a bright wallpaper, you know, it's not like it's terrible, but you will see an improvement with darker wallpapers. You will see posts in things like the Facebook Surface Duo group or on the subreddit of people saying the same sorts of anecdotal reports or mileage. As always, may vary, but in my experience and the experience of others, use a dark wallpaper, stretch that battery life just a little bit longer. And last but not least, this is something that I actually find myself using quite a bit. If I'm going to take a photo or a video in particular, I'm not going to use my Surface Duo because the camera just isn't that great. It's there in a pinch, it's totally fine, but it's not my go-to. I will pick up my Pixel 3 if I need to do something like that. In fact, earlier today I shot a brief video, but I don't want to post it from here. My sim's not in here, so I want to put it on my Surface Duo. Well, you can say, well, hey, if it's a video, just let it upload to Google Photos and then download it over here and then post it. And that's fine, but it's going to upload to the internet and then you're going to download it again, and it's kind of a pain in the butt. And maybe we're not talking about just pictures and photos. I don't know, maybe we're just talking about files or whatever, but a lot of people that use a Duo do have a secondary phone that they use for some other things. It's not super uncommon. So there's a really quick, simple, awesome way to move your files or your photos or your videos from your secondary phone to your Duo or vice versa. And it's called Nearby Share, and no one's talking about it. It's kind of like AirDrop, but it works for Android and it's built into your phone. So what you do is you go on the phone you're sending something from, like this picture I took here, which is being used, boy, that phone's dirty, in a thumbnail for a video. And I'm going to simply select the Share button down at the bottom, and then you will see Nearby Share as an option down there. So I'm going to click on Nearby Share, and it will show Shane's phone as being available. So I'm going to click on that. Well, then what's going to happen on my Surface Duo is I'm going to get a notification here saying, hey, this Pixel is sharing stuff with you. Do you want to accept it? Hit accept. I'm just in near proximity. That's all it is. And boom, just like that, there's the photo. It has been sent to my Surface Duo. It works for videos as well. Obviously, it takes a little bit longer to send a video over because it's a bigger file, but it works super duper well. You literally saw in essentially real time how well that works. And you can do this with any sort of file at all on your phones. So guys, that is my number two list of Surface Duo tips and tricks. I would love to know from you guys. I'm sure there's some that have not been in either video. Let me know in the comments down below what I have missed. Share your beloved tips and tricks with other Surface Duo users down there in the comments. Stay tuned for more coverage just like this. And until next time, say it with me. Stay nerdy, my friends. If you enjoy my content, please consider becoming a Scary If Literal member. You'll get access to a whole bunch of emoticons to use with live streams and a shout out on an upcoming video. Thanks as always for your continued support.